Liquid metal in laptops. Is there a point in doing this? Can it make your laptop run faster, cooler, or quieter? Let's find out. First, a quick intro to liquid metal if you are unfamiliar with it. CPUs and GPUs generate a lot of heat, so we use heat sinks and fans to cool them down. Transfer of heat from the chips to the cooler usually requires a thermal interface material because of imperfect contact. The common kind of thermal interface material is called thermal paste, and as you can imagine, it is a paste. Liquid metal is an alternate type of thermal interface material which can be used instead of conventional thermal pastes. The advantage of liquid metal over thermal paste is its better thermal conductivity, which can lead to better temperatures on your CPU, which in turn could improve noise levels and performance of your system. But the downside is that while thermal paste is not usually electrically conductive, liquid metal is. Hence, you need to be extra careful while applying liquid metal to not spill it over, or it can short components around the die. So, let's test if liquid metal is beneficial in laptops. I've already run some benchmarks and collected some stats using thermal paste. Let's replace a thermal paste with liquid metal and run these tests again to see the differences. Before we begin, I should note that we are using a Dell XPS 13 9370 for today's tests. It is an ultrabook with a relatively low power CPU and an integrated Intel GPU. So I expect the results to be roughly the same for laptops with a similar CPU and form factor. The impact of liquid metal will definitely be higher for desktops and more powerful laptops, and we'll be taking a look at both of them in later videos, so stay tuned. We need to open up the laptop first. The exact procedure for doing this will vary between laptops, but you can usually find guides and teardowns online. iFixit in particular is a great source. In case of XPS 13, the process is quite simple, though it requires a slightly uncommon screwdriver. Remove the 8 screws at the bottom using a T5 screwdriver, then gently unclasp the base using guitar picks or something similar. Once the base is removed, it's a good idea to unplug the battery from the motherboard before proceeding, so I will do that next. The heat pipes are immediately visible and held in place by 4 Phillips head screws. Unscrew them to release the base plate and the heat pipes. You will see the existing thermal paste underneath. I should note that what you see here is not the stock thermal paste that came with the laptop. I replaced that with an aftermarket paste a while ago. Anyway, let's wipe away all the thermal paste and clean both the base plate and the dies using isopropyl alcohol. Now we are ready to apply liquid metal. A note of caution. Liquid metal should not be used with aluminum, so please don't use liquid metal if your base plate is made of aluminum. From what I have seen, most laptops have copper or nickel-plated copper in the base plate, so it's safe to use liquid metal in that case. There are several liquid metal options to choose from, and perhaps the most popular choice is thermal grizzly conductor knot, and that's what I'm going to use today. It comes with a syringe head and I recommend using that. However, instead of squeezing it out directly onto the chip, I'd recommend getting a drop onto another clean surface first. You can then use the included Q-tips to paint the liquid metal onto the CPU and the GPU dies. If you are afraid of spilling it outside the die area, you can use tape to isolate the areas that you want to apply liquid metal on. It might take a fair number of swaps to get the liquid metal properly applied, so be patient. Now you can do the same thing underneath the base plate as well. Paint the liquid metal on and make sure that it stays spread. And once that's done, we are ready to put everything back together. Screw in the heat pipes, plug in the battery, and make sure that your laptop boots. Then put the back cover of the laptop back on, and we are done. So was it worth the trouble of doing all this? Let's compare some tests using thermal paste and liquid metal to find out. Starting with Heaven benchmark. This is a popular graphics benchmark, and though I don't expect anyone to game using this integrated GPU, it does provide insight into what liquid metal can do. Looking at the CPU temperatures over time, we can see that the liquid metal temperatures are lower than that using thermal paste initially by about 7 degrees, but the gap shrinks soon to just about 1 degree Celsius. Correspondingly, the benchmark score while using liquid metal is slightly higher by about 0.5%. Both these differences are quite small and can even happen between different applications of the same thermal material. Interestingly, a second consecutive run yielded the same scores in both scenarios. Heaven benchmark is relatively long, so I think that the CPU settles into the same frequency in the majority of the time for both cases. A shorter benchmark, like the Geeks 3D Furmark, paints a slightly different picture. The temperatures follow a similar trend, and the first run scores are identical for both liquid metal and thermal paste. The scores dip in the second consecutive run, but the liquid metal score does not dip as much as the thermal paste score. This could be because the chips do not reach thermal equilibrium during the short benchmark runs, and the liquid metal keeps the chips cooler, allowing longer boost durations. So far, the graphics benchmarks have not given us persuasive results to use liquid metal. And the CPU benchmarks follow a similar trend. Liquid metal keeps the temperature significantly lower only for the first 10 seconds or so under load. This results in better scores under short benchmark runs, especially under heavy multi-core load, and no significant differences in longer running loads. One other thing to note is that since liquid metal can keep things cooler in short bursts of CPU and GPU activity, I did notice that the fans tend to turn on a little less frequently during day-to-day use of the laptop. The gains are significantly small compared to high-performance systems. For example, I deleted my i7-8700K and the temperatures dropped by almost 20 degrees. More on that in another video. You should also consider the difficulty of opening up your system and removing your cooler. In some laptops, the CPU may be mounted on the other side of the motherboard, which requires significantly more disassembly to replace a thermal compound. I want to emphasize once again that this liquid metal was compared against an aftermarket thermal paste, which is Arctic Silver 5. Aftermarket pastes are usually significantly better than the stock ones, so if your laptop is running too warm or too loud, I'd recommend switching the stock thermal paste to an aftermarket one first. And if that doesn't help, you may try out liquid metal. And that's it for today's video. Hope you guys found it helpful and interesting. Like I mentioned, I will be following up with videos on liquid metal application and results in desktops and other classes of laptops, so stay tuned for that. Please hit that like button if you like this video and subscribe for more content. And I'll see you soon in the next one. Thanks for watching.